So coming back, we will discuss when to start the answer writing, three different phases of the answer writing, the daily answer writing versus full length test, brainstorming and structure making, writing introduction, body and conclusion, presentation tools, the UPSC Spiceman copy of the GS mains. We will see that also. We will see what should be the self-evaluation parameters. Then we will also analyze few topers copies. Then we will see most common mistakes which are done by the participants, the students, and finally we will end up with some of the important tips, and I will share what Didemy offers for the people, for the students, in the context of answer writing. Okay, so to start with, this session is a part of the webinar series which we are carrying on, and this is the list of the webinars which we have already conducted on economy, current affairs, GS mains preparation, and now today we are on the answer writing. The next webinar is on 12th of October, and that is about essay writing, and after that we have more webinars coming up. So you should attend all these webinars for strengthening your preparation. These webinars are presented by the Didemy IAS, and we are standing for your success. These are our credentials. Now first of all, in the last session I discussed about how to prepare for the GS mains, right? And I told you how to utilize the time between the prelims and the mains 2020. In that context, I want to bring the answer writing, right? So first let me share the time period which should be utilized in three manner. So the time between now and the mains examination you should divide into three categories: between now and the prelims result, then from 16th November to the 20th December, and the last one in for the complete revision. In the first period you should complete the 40% of syllabus of GS mains and the optional one paper. Then in the second phase you should complete 60% of the syllabus of the GS paper and paper number 2 or any one paper of the optional. Then from 21st December there should be complete focus only and only on the revision, nothing else. Okay, now in this context I also told you about answer writing, that in the answer writing we have to focus in three different manner. We will start from 12th of October, because there are many people appearing in different examination on 11th of October, and from this time till the 15th of November we will focus upon minimum 2 questions and up to 4 questions on a daily basis, and 10 questions which will be in the form of kind of sectional test on the weekend, that is on the Saturday or Sunday. Then on the, in case of optional, you will follow the same mechanism, either write 2 questions daily or 4 questions daily and 10 questions on the weekend. Similarly, for the essay writing, you will be having every Sunday one test. You write one essay and make the structure of one essay. From 16th of November to 20th December, you will write 4 questions daily and full test on the weekend. 4 questions daily and full test on the weekend. And here, full test of the essay. From 21st of December to the 17th of June, you will write full test, full test, full test. Okay. So this, this is the methodology which I want to suggest. And in this context, let us see how best we can inculcate, how best we can include the answer. So about daily schedule, so I told you we have to divide the period into three categories, and now what should be the daily timetable for this period. Okay, so the daily timetable should include three things: the answer writing, the GS content, and the optional. In the GS content you will work on current affairs as well. Now 1 hour for the daily revision, 5 hours for the optional, 30 minutes to 1 hour for the optional answer writing, 1 hour for the daily current affairs, 1 hour for the GS answer writing, and 5.5 hours for the GS mains content development. So you can see I have allocated around 30 minutes to 60 minutes, that is 1 hour for the optional and 1 hour for the GS answer writing. So how to best utilize them, how to ensure that we are getting the best out of this time. Okay, so let us see that. So for that, we'll discuss everything. And first of all, there are a lot of queries which I face, especially from those people who are the beginners or who have done the preparation for the prelims, that sir, at what time should we start the answer writing? Should we build the content or should we directly jump into the answer writing, or both of them should be done simultaneously? So my answer is, answer writing is a skill, it's an art, and for that you need the basic content. So first you should work on the content. If you are not working on the content, then in the answer writing you don't know what kind of mistake you are making. You will not be able to bring the best in the introduction, body and the conclusion, right? So first you should build the content. At least go through the entire syllabus once, or cover one paper, for example GS2 paper, GS3 paper, and do the answer writing when you are covering the paper simultaneously. So first thing is that you have to cover the GS main syllabus. Simultaneously you can do the answer writing, but without GS main syllabus you should not start the answer writing, right? So without main syllabus coverage you should not start the answer writing. Once you are ready, once you have covered the GS main syllabus, then there are three different phases which should be followed. So what are these three different phases? Let me discuss these three phases. Yeah, so the first phase is for those people who have just started and who consider themselves that they are not good at answer writing. So for you people, first of all, when you are writing the answer, have no time limit. Means you take 30 minutes in writing the answer of 10 marks, not a problem, right? But your focus should be on, you know, getting to the depth of the question, reading the question again and again, gathering more information about the topic and then writing, right? And you should write two questions on a daily basis. Out of these two questions, what you can do, you can write one structure of the question and one you can go for full answer writing. Okay, so this can be utilized by those people also who have not done the answer writing for a long time. They should also start with this. First of all, your focus should be on the quality. Then you can continue this practice for 2-3 months, but definitely if you are in the race of mains 2020, don't follow this. In that case, you should start the next phase within 1 week. Okay, you should practice this answer in the UPSC SpiceMan answer writing sheet only. I will tell more about UPSC SpiceMan answer sheet and I will show you the screenshots, right? Now once you are thorough with that phase, then comes the second phase. So in the first phase, you were just working on the content, you were just working on, you know, bringing the best, utilizing all the resources, all the technologies, without caring about the time limit. You can take 20 minutes, but write the best answer. In the second phase, we will go to the next level. So how do you recognize that this is your second phase of the answer writing? First of all, that when you see the question, immediately some points come in your mind. And there is a huge phobia of the answer writing, that I don't know answer writing, I never did answer writing, I am not good at writing things. So many things, so many issues, they percolate in your mind. So when that fear has disappeared, then you are ready for the second phase. Now start fixing the time limit. Okay, start fixing the time limit. For example, time limit of 7 minutes for 10 marker, time limit of 14 minutes for the 20 marker, like that. So similarly, for 1 minute you will have 25 words to write, in 6 minutes you will have 150 words to write. I will discuss more about it in, yeah. So here you will start fixing the time limit, then slowly increase the speed, work on increasing the speed. Okay, work on increasing the speed. Okay, so people are joining in. Yeah, so minimum 4 questions daily you have to write in this phase. Now for these 4 questions, what strategy you can follow is, you can make the structure of two answers and you can write two answers completely. How to make the structure, I will tell you. I will tell you about that in very detail. Okay. So in this phase, you are fixing the time limit, you are increasing the number of questions, you are focusing on the speed, and you are now getting the evaluation done from other people because you are now at a certain level, right? And you should practice this strategy for 1 to 2 months. But if you are appearing for mains 2020, then you should start it immediately as soon as possible. Then you can't wait. Okay. Now phase 3 of the answer writing practice. So in this phase 3, you are completely bounded by the time. You are completely bounded by the time. In this phase, you have to completely focus on the answer writing as per the UPSC standard, right? Completely as per the UPSC standard. Here you don't have a choice to do something else. So strict time limit you have to put here. You have to follow the word limit also strictly, and you have to write as if you are writing the UPSC IAS examination. And on a daily basis, you should attempt 8 to 10 questions. For these 8 to 10 questions, again, you will be making the structure for 4 questions. You will be writing 4 questions completely. Okay. Now these 8 questions, you can classify them like 4 questions from the optional and 4 questions from the GS. Okay. So it is not that you have to do this answer writing only for GS. Rather, you have to maintain a balance. You have to do this for both GS and the optional paper. Are you getting my friends? Now, you should attend the full length test and attempt 20 questions in this phase. And you should continue this practice till your mains examination. So those people who are appearing in the 2020 examination, you should practice this thing very, very, immediately, right? As soon as possible. Now, there is a big question. Sir, what is the benefit of daily answer writing? And should I go for daily answer writing or should I go for both? So the answer is both have their own importance. First, let us come to the daily answer writing. Suppose you are writing 2 questions daily and you are getting the evaluation for these 2 questions. So what are the benefits? First of all, a habit builds up. For example, you fix a time that at 10 a.m. daily, I will write 2 answers no matter what. In whatever corner of the world I am, I will write the answer of the 2 questions. Habit builds up. Secondly, when you write today's answer, and there is an evaluation of the previous answer, yesterday's answer, so basically what you can do, you can learn from these mistakes, learn from the mistakes of previous day. For example, your examiner has told that your answers lack introduction or they lack body, the conclusion is not good. There can be so many feedback which you can get. So include these feedback in today's answer. Try ensuring that you are not repeating the same mistake which you did yesterday. In this manner, you will be improving on a day-to-day basis. So this daily answer writing should be used for improving the quality of the answer, for working on every component, introduction, body, conclusion. There is no substitute for the daily answer writing. Okay. There is no substitute for the daily answer writing. You must do that. Now, in this daily answer writing, you have built up the quality. Now you are aware about which component to work upon. Here comes the role of full mock test or sectional test. You can also practice sectional test of 10 questions daily. No, 10 questions on a weekly basis. In this sectional test, your focus will be on completing the paper थ्रू स्पीड एंड मैनेजिंग मल्टीपल क्वेश्चंस साइमल्टेनियसली, स्विचिंग ओवर द क्वेश्चंस So these are your focus in this full length test or the sectional test, right? So sectional test have their own advantages and the daily answer writing has their own advantages. We have to mix both. So what is the best way? You practice 2 question daily and 10 question on every Saturday or Sunday. So from Monday to Friday, 2 question on Saturday or Sunday, 10 question. This is the best way you should improve, because quality will be taken care during the week. And speed management, switching over, that will be taken care during the full mock test or sectional test. Are you getting my friends? Is it clear everyone? So this is the way you should approach. So my friends, those people who are watching the video on YouTube, you are invited to the Zoom. I have just shared the Zoom link. You can join from that. Okay. So now, the next step, before you start answer writing, you must be thorough with the basics of the syllabus. You must have the syllabus printed and that should be pasted on your wall. Then you should have a good grasp over the previous year questions. You must have the previous year questions compilation, and you must have the proper grasp of the previous year questions. Keep going through the previous year questions again and again. Okay. Now, there are some general tips which I want to tell you, right? So first of all, for answer writing, the biggest problem the candidates do is they don't understand the demand of the question, right? Demand of the question is very, very crucial. If you don't understand the demand of the question, then nothing can help you. Okay, nothing can help you. So for this, for justifying this, I will show you a small clip of one of the UPSC evaluator who is a professor, famous professor, and you can just see that how much important this is. Okay, so basically this person is answering to the question that when UPSC is asking you to check the question, check the answer, then what are the things that you are looking into, or is UPSC giving some particular instruction on how to evaluate the copy or not? Okay, so just listen to this carefully and then you will be appreciating what he is trying to say. Okay,
there are two things. One is that, for example, if I am a very seasoned examiner, quote unquote, for example, one person is from 10 years is examiner in IAS. So people will not say anything to him or her, right? Because he is already useful. But somebody is very recently joined in this whole band of examiners. So unko kya bolte? Because ye jo question's answer hai, that is not a BA or MA examination. क्वेश्चन आंसर नंबर 1, जो वहां पर चेक करने वाले हैं वो बीए और एमए के एग्जाम पेपर चेक करते हैं. दे आर पीपल लाइक मी, राइट? दोज आर प्रोफेसर्स. द फर्स्ट इंस्ट्रक्शन इज देयर, इट्स नॉट योर स्टूडेंट्स दोज आर राइटिंग आंसर. दे आर वेरी डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ पीपल, दैट इज द प्रॉब्लम. सो डोंट चेक.
व्हाट ही इज सेइंग इज वेरी सिंपल, दैट व्हेन यूपीएससी इज आस्किंग the evaluator to check the copy, they are not giving any particular instruction, but definitely they say that this question is not the question of the graduation, because most of the evaluator are professors of the colleges, university. They have been evaluating the copy of the different students, and the questions in the graduation or in the university are very, very repetitive. They are repeating every year. You will find 60-70% questions they repeat every year. But in UPSC, they are asking a new question every moment. I mean, if there are 20 questions in one year, all of them are completely new. Yeah, topic might be repeating, but question will never repeat. So the examiner has to understand the question in multiple manner. They have to go through the question, read again and again. Matlab, question ko bar bar padhna hai. They have to read the question again and again. That is the point. Is it now clear? So this is the point this professor is making, right? So this is the importance of understanding of the question. And this will be different for every question. That is the point this person is trying to make. Okay? So understanding the demand of the question is the first and the most important thing. And for that, you have to read the question again and again. You have to know the key terminology, what is the meaning of discuss, what is the meaning of evaluate. There are so many other things, right? So I will tell you more about that in the end of the session. What is the meaning of different things? So understanding the demand of the question is the first important thing. Now, the second important thing is brainstorming. Okay? Brainstorming. So when you see the question, immediately just underline the keywords and use your pen or paper whatsoever, your pen or pencil whatsoever, and underline the keyword, okay, so that you do not miss any point. Because when you see any topic, your mind suddenly gives lot of point. If you just write them, you will not forget when you are writing the actual answer. So this has to be done for every question. For example, this is the question of UPSC, and this question says coastal sand mining, whether legal or illegal, poses one of the biggest threats to our environment. Analyze the impact of sand mining along the Indian coast. So here, what are the key words? Coastal sand mining, biggest threat to our environment. Analyze the impact of sand mining along the Indian coasts, citing specific examples. So these are the keywords. When you are reading the question, read the question 3 times and underline the keyword again and again. So the question is about analyzing the impact of the sand mining and giving the example. So this is the major question, right? And the context of the question is coastal sand mining being a biggest threat, right? So this is how you should read the question carefully, and immediately just write down the point of impact. Just okay, what is the impact? Okay, it will impact the biodiversity, it will impact the local population, right? It will impact the river ecology, like that. So just write the keywords here only, so that you don't miss those points later on. And similarly, what are the examples? So in the examples, you can mention different example, whatever comes to your mind. So this is called brainstorming. Understanding the question, reading the question, underlining the keywords, and then basically writing down the important point which come to your mind. This is the first and the starting point. Okay, so brainstorming, this is the first important thing. Now, what should be the parameters of brainstorming? I told you that, okay, underline the keyword, and then for every keyword just jot down the point that come to your mind. Now, this brainstorming, if it is done through a systematic process, and if you have certain dimensions that you must include or you can include, then nothing like that. Okay, nothing like that. So for that, what you have to do is you have to follow certain basic point. You have to think through certain dimension. So for every question, just think what can be the introduction, what can be the body, what can be the conclusion, right? I will discuss how to write body, how to write introduction, how to write conclusion in the upcoming part of the session. But when you see the question of coastal sand mining, just think what can be the introduction, what can be the body, what can be the conclusion, right? And then start thinking from what kind of diagram I can include. Can I include the diagram of impact, or it can be the diagram of threats? Then can I give some case study? Can I give some recent example? What facts can I quote? What references can I give? Can I give the reference of any government report? So basically, all these dimensions you must have it as a checklist in your mind when you are brainstorming. And in the UPSC answer sheet, there is a, like in the question and answer booklet, इन द एंड देर आर सम रफ पेजेस. दीज रफ पेजेस दे आर गिवन फ्रॉम दिस ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग. सो यू यूज दीज टूल्स टू ब्रेनस्टॉर्म ऑन एवरी टॉपिक. सो स्लोली व्हेन यू आर राइटिंग वन क्वेश्चन टू क्वेश्चन डेली बेसिस, देन इट विल टेक टाइम बिकॉज यू हैव टू थिंक थ्रू दीज 7-8 डायमेंशंस. बट स्लोली स्लोली व्हेन एवर यू आर बिकमिंग मोर एफिशिएंट प्रोफिशिएंट, स्लोली स्लोली यू विल ऑटोमेटिकली डू दिस काइंड ऑफ वर्क. आई मीन योर माइंड विल ऑटोमेटिकली स्टार्ट कलेक्टिंग द रेलिवेंट थिंग फ्रॉम द फ्रॉम योर नॉलेज बेस, फ्रॉम योर रिविजन ऑफ द कंटेंट. Like it will automatically start searching for diagram, case study, facts and references. So in the starting it will be a conscious thing and slowly slowly you will automatically learn how to do that. You will not struggle. Okay. So brainstorming has to be done through all these parameters. What I will recommend, note them down, take a printout and paste in your study room. And whenever you are doing the answer writing, just think through all these parameters. Okay, I will discuss about this parameter in the upcoming discussion. So for the value addition, you have multiple tools. You can give reference of the multiple government document. For example, Niti Aayog, Economic Survey. And whenever you are quoting some point, must write the reference so that examiner knows that yes, you are quoting or you are pointing out the point of a particular government document. Similarly, next is you can have important quotations, for example, quotation from Mahatma Gandhi, quotation from, important philosophers, and you can also list down the important terminologies of every subject. For example, in the GS paper 2, there is terminology called cooperative federalism. In the GS 3, there is terminology called sustainable development, inclusive growth. You must have a list of these terminology so that you can utilize them in the introduction, body or conclusion. Then you must go through the important statements of the Prime Minister and President, especially the speeches of Independence, Republic Day, and you should find the important word from there, catchy statement from there. They are using very well researched material there. Okay. Then here there are other documents which you can go through, second ARC report and Yojana chief editor's desk page. So Yojana is a monthly magazine. In this monthly magazine, there is a first page. Open that page. From that page, you read that page multiple times, underline the keywords, write the important words separately, and then you try to use them wherever possible, right? So this is another way to do the value addition, right? So I hope you are getting the idea about the content, right? So far we have discussed daily answer versus full length, both have to be done. Number two, I discussed the brainstorming. In the brainstorming, you have to utilize introduction, body, conclusion and the value addition tool, and these are the value addition tool. So whenever you see the topic, see the question, just start thinking through these value addition tools, right? And slowly, slowly your mind will be equipped. It will be comfortable in writing the, collecting the important facts. Now, what are the important key value addition tools? I have told you diagrams, case studies, key facts, and the references. Okay. So diagrams can be of multiple type. I will tell you case study, latest example. For example, if it is about crime against women, you can give the example of Hathras. If it is the case of man versus animal conflict, you can give the example of that elephant which was killed in Kerala, like that. Important facts you can include from Economic Survey, from daily newspaper, like that. References of Economic Survey, Niti Aayog, like that. Okay. Now the next important thing is the presentation. Presentation is very, very important. Okay. If things are not presented in the right manner, then no one will value that. Do you agree? Yes or no? The answer is yes, definitely. So what to do for the presentation? First of all, there is a big question about handwriting. Sir, how should be the handwriting? Should it be like wonderful or should it be, will it be okay if I have just normal handwriting? The answer is, in the UPSC, they are looking for legible handwriting, which can be read by anyone. They are not looking for a wonderful handwriting. They are just looking for the basic handwriting, which can be read by anyone, right? So this is the first thing. Secondly, you should add diagram, but don't overdo. This is also important. So if there are 20 questions, don't add the diagram to 20 questions. Maybe you will use the diagram for 10 to 12 questions, right? So now there is a fashion. People are using so many diagrams. It is not the only way to improve the marks. Yes, you can use the diagram, but not in every question. Then you should use the variety of diagram. Don't use the same diagram again and again. So you can use the flow chart, tree diagram, schematics, the tree and the maps, etc. Then there are so many other kind of diagrams which you must use. Yeah. So I was telling about using the diagrams, but not overdoing this. So now next is, you must use the headings and the highlights. Okay, headings must be used. You can use maximum two pen and you can use pencil for the diagram, and this is permitted by the UPSC. So UPSC has clearly permitted this thing, right? So heading you should use as much as possible. For example, in the coastal mining question, you can use the impact, you can use the examples. So these can be used as the headings, right? Now in the heading also, impact, again it can be looked upon from economic impact, sociological impact, environmental impact. So these are the subheadings, right? So headings and subheadings both have to be used suitably. You must use so that examiner can identify that, okay, the impact part has been answered by the candidate. Then only UPSC can, the examiner can identify. Otherwise, it is not possible for examiner to identify. Similarly, what are the examples, right? So this is how you have to analyze. Then there is a big debate whether I should write the point format or in the paragraph format or in both format, right? So answer is, there should be a mix of both. Paragraph, it can be used for the introduction, for the conclusion, for the transition, or it can be used for the debate, like when there is a debate kind of thing going on, right? Then you have to write the point and the counterpoint simultaneously. Then you can use the paragraph. Otherwise, you should use the point, because using the point, it means that you are basically highlighting one point and moving to the next point, okay? Now, you must underline the keywords in your answer. So if there is a question of coastal mines, sand mining, whatever keywords are there, at least 5% of the content should be underlined in the answer, but don't overdo, okay? Many people, what they start doing, they start underlining entire line. Wo nahi karna hai. What you have to underline is only the keyword, only the important words, not every point, okay? So you have to do like that. Then you have to, you can use the capital words, right? So either you underline, or for highlighting the important point, you can write them in the capital word so that those words are clearly visible to the examiner, right? So this is how you can highlight and point out the important point. This will give you better presentation. You will be able to differentiate different point at different places. Why this is to be done? Because examiner has so many copies and the time is very, very limited. Examiner ko jyada paise nahi milte. Examiner do not get much money for evaluation. The amount is very, very low. I don't know the actual amount, but it should be around maybe 100 rupees per copy. So they have maybe maximum 5 to 10 minutes for evaluating one copy. So what they will do, they will just flip through the page and they will just look into whether the keywords are available in the copy or not. Agar keyword hai, they will give the answer. If they are not able to find the keyword, then you will not get the marks, right? So you have to, you know, make your keywords visible to the examiner so that examiner do not have to struggle for looking the keyword. He or she don't have the time. They are not interested in your stuff. You have to show to them that yes, I have the keyword, I know about this point. Okay, so this keyword, capital, point, paragraph, this presentation is important so that examiner is interested in your copy. He or she spends more time and awards more mark. Are you getting my friends? So that is why presentation is important. And even here you can see that these are the instructions of UPSC which are given in the question come answer booklet, and then they are clearly mentioning certain things that you have to write legibly and neatly in the ink, and you can use pencil for drawing the diagrams, making the sketches, etc. Right? And then you have the rough work, and this booklet should be used, this rough work should be used at the just rough pages should be used for the rough work, right? If you are cancelling out any work, if you want to, you know, cancel any, for example, you have to write one answer out of two answer, and by mistake you started answering the first option, but later on you realize that you can do much better in the second option. So now you want to cancel the first option and you want to start writing the answer to the second question. In that case, you will write cancelled. You will use this word cancelled in a very clear manner so that examiner knows that okay, this option is not answered by the student, and this evaluation, the evaluation will be done for the another question, right? So this UPSC instruction, this is a screenshot of UPSC answer booklet which is available on the UPSC website, right? I am highlighting the important point so that you do not do these silly mistakes in the exam. Now there are some general and very important tip. There is a big question, sir, how about language? Sir, my grammar is not good, I don't know the flowery English, I am not from convent education, or sir, I am a literature guy, am I writing too flowery language, like that. So simple answer is that you use the simple layman terms, layman language. For that you can use NCERT language, you can go for Yojana magazine, you can read Niti Aayog, you can read Economic Survey, and just try and find that their language is very very simple, their sentences are very clear, they are using simple grammar, no need of flowery language. You don't have to do that. What you have to do is just have a command of your content and write that in simple sentences. Okay, but very important, don't use social media language. Don't use the words like ASAP, as soon as possible. No, that will not work. Okay, because here it is the exam hall, and it is not the WhatsApp or Facebook or anything else. So there is a tendency in the present generation to use this kind of language. That should not be there. Now this is very very important, which I want to tell you. Every word is important. See, there are two type of questions which come in the exam: the 10 marks question and the 20 marks question. Okay, I'm talking about the GS paper. This for 10 marker and the 15 marker. Okay, so for 10 marker you have how much time? For 1 mark you have 180 minute upon 250 mark, so you have 0.72 minute for every mark. That means for 10 mark you have 7.2 minute. Okay, for 15 mark similarly you will be having around, you know, 12 minute or even less, in fact. So yeah, in around 11 minute you will be having, right? 7 minute and 11 minute. Now out of the 7 minute you will be spending 1 minute to 1.5 minute for the thinking of the point, that is from brainstorming. Jo maine aapko bataya tha ki what will be the body, what will be the conclusion, what will be the diagram which I will be using, finding the keyword, reading the question carefully, understanding the demand of the question, right? So in this whole process you will end around 1 minute out of the 7 minute. So you will be ending up only with 6 minute, and in this 6 minute you have to write 150 word. Okay, so basically in the 10 marker question there is a word limit of 150 words. So in just 6 minute you have to write 150 word. That simply means that in 1 minute you have to write 25 words. And if we see the sentence, the number of sentences that can be made from this 25 word, तो 25 वर्ड से हम लोग मैक्सिमम दो सेंटेंस बना सकते हैं, दो सेंटेंस बना सकते हैं. इसका मतलब इन वन मिनट वी हैव टू राइट दो सेंटेंस, टू सेंटेंसेस, राइट. एंड फॉर वन मार्क वी हैव टू राइट 15 वर्ड्स, राइट, बिकॉज फॉर 10 मार्क वी हैव टू राइट 150 वर्ड्स, सो फॉर वन मार्क वी हैव टू राइट 15 वर्ड्स, राइट. तो द पॉइंट आई वॉन्ट टू मेक इज यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट वेन यू कंप्लीट वन मिनट यू आर कंप्लीटिंग 25 वर्ड्स, when you complete 15 words you have written the answer to the one mark question. Okay, now to get this one mark you have to impress the examiner with a high quality of word. These 15 word or average, you can say one sentence for every mark, every sentence will be of high quality. That is the point I want to make. Aapka har ek sentence important hona chahiye, right. Every sentence has to be of the high quality. You cannot compromise in the quality of your content. You cannot compromise in that. Okay, are you getting my friends? So you have to just keep in mind this thing that every minute, every sentence carries some weightage, and for getting one extra mark in the exam hall you have to utilize every minute, every sentence in the best possible manner. So word as well as time, both are important. You have to understand that. That means you have to look for the suitable content and you have to utilize every single second of the exam hall. So for utilizing every second, well, you must have this digital wristwatch. So this is the first homework that I am giving to you. Immediately after this session, please buy this wristwatch, right? Why? Because it will give you the timeline. If you don't follow the timeline, then you will end up wasting the time in the starting. In the end, you will be having a lot of pressure, and finally when you leave the exam hall, you will be leaving many questions unattended, and that will be like disastrous. So digital wristwatch is very, very important. Then you have to just keep checking the time, maybe in after every 5 minutes, right. Have a watch over the minute, over the wristwatch, right. In fact, as a student, you always must have this timeline and this wristwatch with yourself. Don't rely on the mobile, etc. Because using the mobile means there is a lot of social media there and it can distract you. So don't use that much of social media. Rather, you just use the traditional watch. Okay. Now, evaluation. So evaluation is very important, right? So first of all, whenever you write the answer, immediately after the answer, yes, Ashutosh, wristwatch is allowed, definitely allowed, it is allowed, okay. So immediately after the writing of answer, you should evaluate it yourself, okay. You should evaluate it yourself. Why? Because once you evaluate yourself, in the first instance only, you will realize your mistake. And you will think, oh yaar, I did this blunder, I did this silly mistake, okay. So just by looking at your own answer in the first instance only, you are able to understand many of your mistake, and you have to maintain a mistakes register. So this is the second task you will be having. What you have to do, you buy a register or make a separate file of the A4 sheet and start writing the mistake of your copies. Start writing the kind of mistake you made in the day 1, in the day 2, in the day 3, and when you write the answer of next day, pick up the last day revision register, answer mistake register, and think what I have to do next time so that I don't repeat this mistake. Are you getting? Like, you have to be very systematic, scientific. This evaluation should be giving you some action point so that the same thing is not repeated in the next question, the next answer. Are you getting, my friends? Then only this is useful, otherwise this is useless. So the first task is buy a wristwatch. Second task is maintain a separate file for the answer writing mistake, where after every answer writing you will be writing down, I made this mistake, even if it is grammatical mistake, even if this is exceeding word limit, write that, otherwise you will not be able to improve upon that, okay. So do that. So self-evaluation is very, very important. It helps you know what is missing. Okay. Now, another thing that you can do, if not for every question, but for maybe one question daily, you must rewrite the same question again. Right? For example, you have written the answer about parliament working. Okay? The parliament working is not good in India. So, you wrote the first answer by following the systematic pattern. You did the brainstorming. You thought about what should be the introduction, body conclusion, diagram, kya use karna hai, kya references dene hai, mujhe, why it was in news recently, what case study I can quote, which parliament is doing better. Like that, so this is the brainstorming. Once you have done the brainstorming, after the brainstorming, you have written the answer. And then you have evaluated. After evaluation, you again rewrite the same answer and try and ensure that the mistake which you did previously is not repeated again. For example, if previously you exceeded the word limit, this time try to identify that I should not be able to repeat this mistake again. I have not to, I have to ensure that I don't close the word limit. Okay. So this will be acting as a kind of self-made model answer, and in every day just rewrite one answer of the previous day. Through that you will be improving a lot when you see the question earlier and the question later on. Okay, now don't waste time on question which you are not sure of. Okay, don't try to answer every question. Right, in the exam hall you will be getting certain questions which will not be possible to answer. Even in your day-to-day answer writing, they can be question like that. So don't write those questions where you do not know anything. If you write, there will be penalty mark. Kya hoga? Penalty marks aapke upar lagenge, which is not good for your health. Okay. Nowadays UPSC is also doing the penalty marking. Now coming to the first dimension, that is the introduction writing. Theek hai? So introduction writing kaise karni hai? Let me share about that. First of all, read the question carefully. Okay, this is very very important. I already indicated the statement of the very experienced professor. He also says that even examiner has to understand the question carefully, then underline the keyword of the question, and after that you can utilize maximum 10% space for the introduction writing. Okay, so if it is a 150 word question, then you can use around 15 word or maximum 20 word. That means one sentence to two sentence for the introduction. If it is a 250 word question, that is 15 marker, then you can use 25 word to 30 word. That means maybe 2 to 3 sentences. Are you getting? Not more than that. Don't write the complete background. Don't write unnecessary thing. Directly jump into the question. Don't try impressing the examiner by unnecessary irrelevant stuff. Are you getting, my friends? So this only 10% space has to be used for the introduction, not more than that. Okay, what can be the content of introduction? So there is no fixed formula. It varies from topic to topic. So for example, somewhere you can use the definitions, only definition you can use. If there is a question directly asking about the definition, for example, I will show you in the session only, there was a question, define the carrying capacity of the environment, what is the meaning of that. So you can give the definition, you can quote some important facts. For example, if there is a question about agriculture, you can give the context why it was in news recently, right? And you can give the historical dimension, historical evolution, what was the status of parliament at the time of Jawaharlal Nehru, and what is the status today. So this kind of different ways you can choose, and that will depend from paper to paper also. There is no fixed formula. Okay, now in the introduction you can use the quotation also. Many a time it is always preferred to have the quotation. If you have the quotation, for example, if the question is about new education policy, you can use this quotation: education is the basic tool for the development of consciousness and the reconstitution of society. Okay, so this kind of introduction you can use, where you can utilize the quotation. Okay, yeah, so coming back to the main body, how to write the main body. Can you hear me, everyone? Yeah, so for writing main body, again you have to find the keyword and use those keyword in your main body. For example, this is the question: individual parliamentarian's role as the national lawmaker is on a decline, which in turn has adversely impacted the quality of debate and their outcome. Okay, so here we will underline individual parliamentarian, adverse impact on the quality of debate and their outcome. Okay, so when we are giving the answer, we will look into what is the adverse impact and how the quality of debate and their outcome is declining. Okay, we will use these at the subheadings. This is how we have to find the subheading. We should use the language of the question as much as possible so that examiner is able to identify that, okay, you have actually directly hit the demand of the question. So use the exact word, the adverse impact, the decline in the quality of debate and the outcome, like that. Okay, use the exact word, don't use your own word as much as possible. Okay, so for main body there are various tips. For example, you should have the subheading to start each part of the question, right? For example, for this individual parliamentary question, you can write the decline in the individual parliamentarian's role, then the adverse impact, like that. Okay, so use that word. Okay, now use the points. You can write a mix of alphabet and number, or maybe only numbers. So subheading can be written in the form like 1.2, 1.3, like that, so that examiner is able to identify that, okay, this is the point in continuation. Okay, so is tarah ki jo language aapko use karenge, so this will become more systematic, and initially it will take time. I know that it is not easy, but slowly when you start doing this, you learn. So aap bachpan se cycle chalana nahi seekhe the, someday you started, you know, riding the cycle, aapne struggle kiya, aap gire, aapko maybe you got hurt also, aapko chot bhi lagi, but at some point of time you became independent, and after that time you never forgot how to run the cycle kaise chalani hai. Are you getting my friends? So answer writing bhi wahi hai, ye bhi ek skill hai. Aap starting mein struggle karoge, aapko bahut sare sawal aayenge, but there will be a point where you will be independent, you will be super master. Okay, when you are writing the answer in the point format, right? तो मैंने आपको बताया कि या तो आप पैराग्राफ फॉर्मेट में लिखोगे या पॉइंट फॉर्मेट में लिखोगे. सो व्हेन यू आर राइटिंग द आंसर इन द पॉइंट फॉर्मेट, डोंट ट्राई टू राइट द प्रॉपर सेंटेंस, डोंट ट्राई टू राइट द फुल सेंटेंस. यू हैव टू यूज ओनली द कीवर्ड्स, राइट? तो व्हेन यू आर यूजिंग द पैराग्राफ, देन यू हैव टू यूटिलाइज द फुल सेंटेंस, यू हैव टू राइट द प्रॉपर सेंटेंस. अदरवाइज इन द पॉइंट फॉर्मेट जस्ट राइट द कीवर्ड. आई विल शो यू द एग्जांपल ऑफ टॉपर कॉपीज. देन you have to innovate the answers with your presentation. In some question you will be using the diagram of different type, in another question of different type, in some question you will be utilizing the capital words, somewhere you will be underlining the keywords. So you have to innovate different methodologies, different ways for the different questions. A mix of presentation has to be there. Okay, then underlining keywords and capitalizing the key point or committee recommendations, which I already told you. Now coming to the conclusion part. So in the conclusion, first of all, don't write the word conclusion in the answer. Ye word conclusion ka use nahi karna hai, theek hai? We can use the word like way forward, way ahead, forward looking, need of the hour is this that. Okay, so you have to utilize these kind of word, and then you have to write about whatever you want to write. Okay, so ye conclusion ko subheading nahi banana hai. Okay, and this conclusion should be positive one, it should be like forward looking, it should be completely, you know, optimistic, it should not be pessimistic. For example, if there is a question about women's crime, you show some pessimism, you show some optimism that if the youth of this country is made aware about the importance of women, then we can rise to the occasion, something like that. Okay, now I told you that you should do the self-evaluation, ठीक है? लेकिन self-evaluation करना कैसे है? How to do the self-evaluation? This is a big question. So for self-evaluation, you have to first of all appreciate the good points of your answer. So don't always be, you know, in the mode of criticizing yourself. If you have done something good, appreciate that so that you can repeat that again and again. Then you can compare your model answer, compare your answer with the topper's answers. In your batch, there can be some good people who are writing the answers. So compare your answer with those answers. Look at each element of the answer and find areas of improvement. Okay. So you have to look into how is my introduction, how is my body, how is my conclusion, and then see what else could I have done. So maybe you are spending more time in the evaluation as compared to actually writing the answer, because in the evaluation you are going much deeper, you are looking into your own problem, and that exercise cannot replace anything. Next time you will be far better, right? Then look at each element of the answer and find areas of improvement. Then compare the way of presenting the answer. Compare your own answer, the answer of previous day, the rewritten, the answer which you have rewritten again 1 week before, like that. So do the complete analysis, right? Try to incorporate what you have learned in the next answer. As I told you, you must have a, you know, mistake register where you will keep noting down what is the problem which you are facing, okay, and just work upon those problems. So this mistakes register you have to note down. Let your answers be unique, okay? So don't try to copy, you know, the model answer of coaching institute or maybe the model answer of toppers. No, your answer has to be your answer, okay? You are unique one, but that answer should have certain basic things. Uske andar wo basic cheez honi chahiye, case study, you know, key facts, the underlines, the presentation, the capital words, references, diagrams, right? तो वो सब चीजें होनी चाहिए, लेकिन आपका आंसर अलग होगा, सेकंड पर्सन का आंसर अलग होगा, राइट? नाउ व्हाट आर द पैरामीटर? सो व्हाट आर द इंपॉर्टेंट पैरामीटर व्हिच आर यूजुअली यू नो रेफर्ड बाय एंड यूज्ड बाय द डिफरेंट इवैल्यूएटर्स, ओके? तो क्या होना चाहिए? फॉर इंट्रोडक्शन यू कैन गिव 15% वेटेज, फॉर कंप्लीशन ऑफ द आंसर मीन्स इफ देयर आर फोर कंपोनेंट ऑफ द क्वेश्चन, आर यू आंसरिंग ऑल द फोर कंपोनेंट, राइट? सो फॉर दैट देयर इज 25% स्ट्रेंथ. Language of the question, is it to the point, is it, you know, simple? Facts, multidimensional analysis, the presentation, the word limit, conclusion, handwriting, everything matters, everything carries some or the other weightage, okay? So you have to see, are you catering to each and every requirement? Are you able to understand and implement the different dimensions? So this self-evaluation you must do based upon all these parameters, okay? So don't worry my friends, those people who are on the YouTube, I will answer to your queries, don't worry, okay? I will answer to your queries. Now, what has to be written? What to write? Right? So kya likhna hai? So you have to write both traditional and the current content, right? So let me share with you the views of the professor Gurang, who has, you know, talked about this thing also, that what to share, right? So in this clip he has shared some things. So what he is sharing is basically that the evaluators of the copies, they are you know, maybe not aware about the recent example, right? So for you know, getting high marks, we have to give some example from the past, some famous example. For example, if it is a case of women empowerment, we can give the example of Shah Bano, right? That kind of example which everyone can understand, which is like very famous example. If we give that, even that examiner who is not updated, they can give the good answer, okay? So let me share his views. Just understand, try to understand, and I will brief you at the end.
कि वो भी एक प्रोफाइल सर्वे देने लगते हैं कोई कोई चीज को, वो पढ़ते नहीं है. प्रॉब्लम क्या है, कई बार आपको इसलिए मैं आपको बोल रहा हूं कि जो कुछ भी लेटेस्ट है वो भी लिखो और थोड़ा पुराना भी लिखो. कि जो किसी भी एग्जामिनर है वो ज्यादा पढ़ते नहीं है कि अब ये क्या होगा. ट्रिपल तलाक के बारे में उनको ये विलेज ऑर्गेनाइजेशन की बात पता नहीं होगी कि 80 लाख है, उसके 1 लाख मेंबर है. तो आप लिख सकते हो कि there is a such type of Muslim women organization, they have 1 lakh member, तो बोले क्या ये क्या है, ऐसा तो मैंने कभी सुना ही नहीं है। लेकिन उसके साथ आप ट्रेडिशनल कुछ दूसरा पुराना वो चीज भी उस पर डालिए जिससे उसको लगे हाँ ये मैंने पढ़ा है वो उसने भी पढ़ा है, लेकिन आपने जो पढ़ा है वो उसने नहीं पढ़ा होगा। कई बार ऐसा होता है कि वो उसने नहीं पढ़ा होगा, इसीलिए प्रॉब्लम होता है। जैसे अभी वो जो अपनी जो सोशियोलॉजी प्रोफेसर जिसके ऊपर FIR हुआ,
okay, did you get something my friends? He is saying use both traditional and the current content. Maybe the evaluator is not aware about the recent development. So evaluator will, if we see the traditional example, they can appreciate it. And use most common example which are in public domain, which everyone knows, not only that you know about it, okay? So use that. I'm not saying like you can use other also, but must use that content which is like known to everyone, so that you are your copy get marks from every examiner. कोई भी examiner हो लेकिन आपको marks मिलेगा मिलेगा। हमें वैसा ही answer लिखना है कि हमारा answer किसी भी examiner के पास जाए लेकिन हमें तो marks मिलेगा ही मिलेगा। Are you getting? So that kind of answer we have to write. Whosoever checks our copy, it will not matter. Our answer will be getting the good marks by every evaluator. Okay, now these are some of the UPSC spicemen, and this spiceman is available on the UPSC website, and this is like question come answer booklet. So you must download this, and we have given on our website also, and like they have given all the instructions, and you must be aware about this so that in the exam hall you don't struggle with the basic things, right? So they have given the basic instructions, you can go through that. And the most important thing that you must be looking into is this, that there is a limited space. So they are giving the question here and they are just giving like 2 pages for this answer, okay? So you can see that the space is very limited, there is borderline, and you have to write only in this space, right? So those of you who have not written the mains yet, they can see this copy. This copy is given by the UPSC as a spiceman, and this is available on the UPSC website, and we have also given on the our website, okay? So this copy is basically used by the UPSC, and you can see there is very limited space on both the side, you have to leave the space. So the point is that it is not that you have to have lot of content, it is just that you have to write relevant content to the point content, okay? Are you getting my friends? Now there are some of the topers answer sheets. I want to show you to tell you the kind of answers that they have written, right? So that you can appreciate whatever we discussed, okay? So topers answer sheets, you can see this is the one of the answer sheet where you can see this is the introduction part where the person has just written the direct introduction in just 2 lines, and then the person has directly moved to the diagram, the different methods of collection of data about the informal sector. So the first point is this, second point is this. So can you see like to the point, no unnecessary intellectualism. So just observe the introduction and just see the tree diagram which has been used by the person, okay? And then you can see this point format, okay? So if you see the question, first let us see the question. The question is asking about commenting on the data of the sector and the steps which have been taken by the government, okay? So now you can see that the person has used this statement, this line, steps taken by the government, okay? This line the person has used from the language of the question itself, and this is a subheading. Are you getting my friends? So you have to utilize the language of the question itself and take it as a subheading, so that examiner knows that yes, you have given the answer to this part of the question at this point of time, at this point of space. And you can see like they have, the person has given the point format, okay, in the point format, okay? Similarly, this is another question, and in the second question also you can see this kind of tree diagram the person has used. We are not looking to the question content, but just the presentation part. This is the third question here. You can see like this is the introduction part. In the introduction part, only 2 sentences have been given, the first sentence and the second sentence. And the benefits of the globalization, you can see the small, small points have been given. Proper sentences are not written. Similarly, the negative aspects here also, you can see the small, small points have been written and the examples have been given like that. So you can see example WTO, UNFCC. You can use this small, small language and you can include the fact, the case studies, the example just by writing EG, EG. Okay. So this kind of methodology you must use. Are you getting my friends? Now, this is another example, right? So the same point I want to highlight again and again. And you can see here the underlining the keywords. Here again, you can see the small diagram has been used by the person. And again, the impact of the urbanization on caste. You can see this small point have been written, right? Subheading have been used, right? So this is the kind of thing which you should. Then this is another good presentation which I found to be very good to show you the example. And you can see like these are the various subheading, the ethical framework to systematically address this, right? So this is the copy of the second rank holder, one of the, like I think this year or next year. And you can see family, in the family the person has given two different dimension, education two different dimension, governance two different dimension. Like, so you can see like the use, there is a use of proper subheading and the point, right? So there is one more thing which I always say, that you have to differentiate between the dimension and the point, right? So here the person has given the dimension of family, dimension of education, dimension of governance, dimension of legislature, and then under each dimension the person has given the point, these two point, these two point, these two point, right? So if you structure your point in a systematic manner, if you structure your point under the dimension, then you can use the minimum number of word and you can give the maximum number of point, and your answer will be appreciated by the reader. The evaluator can understand the depth of your knowledge, and you can give more number of facts, the case studies, the references, the data, etc. Okay, so this dimension you should include, and inside that you can give the point. Okay, so there is a big question that when people say, sir, there are some topic on which I have lot of data. For example, the topic of about women. Sir, women ke upar to mere paas mein bahut data hai. Main kahan se likhna shuru karun? Sir, if anyone asks me the question why there are high crimes against the women, I have so many point. From where should I start writing? So my friends, first, this thing is not to be done in the answer writing. Rather, this thing has to be done at the time of your revision. You have to make the mind map of your content, right? So that you have, you know, list with priority. Those points which are very, very crucial point, which are very common point, for example, patriarchy and, you know, mindset, all those things. So those things must be included in the answer, and then some unique point from your own research. So the common point and unique point both have to be, you know, combined together and given in the answer. If you ignore the common point and give only the unique point which no one knows, then maybe aapko evaluator ko aisa mile jisko aapka answer pasand nahi aaye. So again the copy is gone. And if you just write the traditional point, not the current point, that is also not suggested. Okay, so you have to use both the traditional as well as the current example, and you have to utilize your revision tools in a proper manner, and you have to differentiate between the dimension and the point. Are you getting my friends? So this is another example. You can see to the point, the person has given only, you know, one line or one and half line, and point is completed. No unnecessary intellectualism, because there is not much space. Aap dekh lijiye na, like every statement is giving almost 1 marks. I already told you that 1 mark means 15 words, right? So this is equal to 1 mark. If you are writing this relevant word, then you are getting 1 mark. Okay, so you have to be very, very specific, where you have to be very, very, you know, to the point. Similarly, you can see this introduction, and in this introduction you can see the person has directly given the definition of administration and the definition of the leadership. Okay, so this is again indicating that if you just give the to the point answer, then this is wonderful. Okay, yeah. So now coming to the main questions, key terminologies, right? So there are various terms which are there. So for example, the first is enumerate, right? The first word is enumerate. So what is the meaning of enumerate? एन्यूमरेट का मतलब क्या होता है, हम ये देखते हैं, ठीक है। या सो लेट अस डिस्कस द की टर्मिनोलॉजीज व्हाइल वी आर राइटिंग द मेंस आंसर्स, ओके, हाउ टू यू नो हाउ टू फ्रेम योर आंसर बेस्ड अपॉन द की वर्ड और द टैग वर्ड विच हैज बीन आस्क्ड इन द क्वेश्चन, ओके। सो फॉर दैट द फर्स्ट वर्ड इज एन्यूमरेट। सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ द वर्ड एन्यूमरेट? जस्ट मीन्स लिस्ट डाउन, नो नीड फॉर द डिटेल्ड एक्सप्लेनेशन, यू डोंट नीड टू एक्सप्लेन द टर्म इन डिटेल, जस्ट लिस्ट डाउन। एंड फॉर एग्जाम्पल एन्यूमरेट द फंडामेंटल ड्यूटीज, जस्ट लिस्ट डाउन द फंडामेंटल ड्यूटीज। एंड दिस इज द प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन, सो I will keep giving you the example of the previous year also. So in this previous year question, you can see enumerate the indirect taxes which have been subsumed in the GST in India. Also comment on the revenue implications of the GST introduced in India since July 2017. So we have to first enumerate the list of indirect taxes which have been included in the GST. Just make a list of these taxes. No discussion of why this is required, what is the importance of GST, nothing, just enumerate, okay. So this is the first type of word that you will find. Second kind of word you will find is narrate, okay. So what is narrate? Narrate is basically more of temporal or time dimension, the sequencing of the answer in the time dimension, right. So for example, narrate the key events in the India's freedom struggle in 20th century. So here you have to make the chronological, you know, discussion of the things, right. Third is define. So again, this term is very, very clear, nothing to, you know, discuss much. You have to write the definition, try to give the exact definition if possible. For example, the definition of untouchability you can give directly from NCERT of 11th class, oh sorry, 12th class. The definition of e-commerce you can give directly as per the draft e-commerce policy. The definition of financial inclusion you can give as per the RBI. In some cases it might not be possible for you to give the exact definition. So in that case, at least try to include the keywords and the key phrases of the definition. For example, if you don't remember the definition of financial inclusion, at least write the important word like accessible, affordable, this kind of word. So you have to find out, okay. And this is the previous year question, UPSC question. So here the question is define the concept of carrying capacity of ecosystem as relevant to an environment, okay. So just define, nothing else, okay. So can you see the kind of type of question they are asking? You have to differentiate between the words and you have to answer accordingly. Enumerate, narrate, define, all three have different meaning. Now next is evaluate or assess or examine. Now what is the difference? So this evaluate, assess, examine, all of them are the same thing, and here you have to provide the detailed explanation, okay. And this is one of the favorite word which is used by the UPSC. Here the best way will be that you give the body 3 or 4 lines in the favor, 3 or 4 lines against. You give the implication, you give the limitation. So this is the most comprehensive discussion that you have to do, because they are asking for the detailed explanation, right? Evaluation or assessment or the examination. So in this you have to write the complete 360 degree dimension, right? The example of the UPSC paper is, for example, examine the linkages between the 19th century Indian Renaissance and the emergence of national identity. So you have to, you know, give the interlinkages, you have to tell the implications and maybe the future consequences or the future development based upon that, okay. So you have to write the comprehensive answer. The second question based upon this word is assess the impact of global warming on the coral life system with example, okay. So again, this is also a comprehensive. You will discuss the impact of global warming on the coral life system. You will discuss what are the other reasons of damage to the coral life system. You will tell the implication of damage to the coral life system, like that. Are you getting? So comprehensive analysis you have to do. Next is opinion, comment or views. So clearly they are asking about opinion or giving the comment or giving the views, right? So here you have to be judgmental. You have to clearly show your, you know, zeal or enthusiasm about the issue. But this opinion should be constructive. This should not be destructive. And as much as possible, avoid giving your own views. Rather, give the alternative, you know, largely acceptable one. For example, there is a, topic of maybe secularism. So secularism is a very debatable topic. You might be having inclination to one political party. Don't try to give your personal opinion. Try to give the references of some unbiased people, some rational people, because UPSC is looking for rational and positive thinking mindset people. They are looking for solution oriented people. So your comment, they reflect your personality. Your comment should be very, very, unbiased, and it should be logical and rational. As much as possible, don't try to give your own individual opinion, rather that opinion which is one of the opinion among the many opinion in the public domain. Okay, so another kind of question you can see here is between the relationship between India and Japan, and they have asked about the comment. So you have to give the comment about this question. The time has come for India and Japan to build a strong contemporary relationship, one involving global and strategic partnership that will have a greater significance for Asia and the world as a whole. Okay, so there you have to give the comment and you have to discuss comprehensively. Similarly, this is the next question. Women's movement in India has not addressed the issue of women of lower strata. Substantiate your view. Substantiate your view means you have to give evidences to your view. Whenever you are writing your view, give evidences, give reference of report, give reference of the good thinkers or leaders, right? Then your view will be more acceptable. The next question, the next terminology is very simple. The purpose or goal or objective or target. So here simple thing is like, what does the topic under want to achieve? So question is very simple. Amid the pandemic and protest, what was the purpose of passing the 3 agricultural bills in the parliament? Justify. Simple question, right? So we have to just write the purpose. What was the purpose of that particular topic? Now this analyze. Analyze is also very, very favorite word which is used by the UPSC. So what is this word? Here you have to exactly do same as evaluate, assess or examination. Means you have to write comprehensive answer plus give your opinion. Okay, so you have to give your own interpretation about the topic in addition to the complete analysis. So this is the kind of question where they are asking you to analyze coastal sand mining. Analyze the impact of sand mining along the Indian coast. So you are giving the point, counterpoint, and then you have to give the own opinion with the proper evidence, right? So jab bhi aapko apni opinion deni hai, try to justify with the help of some fact, because you are not a very big personality. Aapka view bahut zyada matter nahi karta, lekin agar apne view ko aap kahin se substantiate kar dete hain, then nothing like that. Then there is a discuss is also, you know, very simple, that you have to talk to the examiner. So just tell whatever you know about the topic. You can tell more than one opinion. You can tell different opinion given by different people, right? Not only your own opinion. So this is the kind of question which is there based upon this. Discuss the causes of depletion of mangroves and explain their importance in maintaining the coastal ecology, right? So discuss word here has been used. So you have to tell the causes, all the different kind of causes. Okay, now describe is again, you know, kind of detailed explanation, right? So here you will tell the different parts, what it is made up of, its constituents, its characteristics, its attributes, right? So for example, Kerala and Tamil Nadu are more prone to the floods. Describe. So you have to describe in detail. You have to give the detailed explanation. Then critically, this is very, very famous, most used word by the UPSC. Okay, so favorite terminology of UPSC, and they can ask critically examine or critically comment or critically analyze. Okay, critically examine, critically comment or critically analyze. So in this case, you have to write the pros as well as the cons of the point, and as much as possible give the fair unbiased view, right? And you must give a closer feeling to the anyone reading the answer. Means you should bring the different dimension, the different views, and finally zero down to some logical view, right? For example, this controversial judgment of Supreme Court, critically examine. So the starting of the word is critically examine. The Supreme Court's judgment on National Judicial Appointment Commission Act 2014 with reference to the appointment of judges of higher judiciary in India, right? So they're directly asking you to critically examine this statement. So here you have to tell pros, cons, and then you have to give your own opinion, because this topic is very debatable. So they have asked critically examine, and whenever you are giving your own opinion, try to give the evidences from other facts, official data, or the opinion of the very famous personalities, those personalities which are like known to be neutral. Next is elucidate, elaborate, expand, or exemplify. So what is the meaning of elucidate? Means you have to make it clear. Elaborate, expand, you know it, like you have to broaden that topic, you have to give more detail. Exemplify, it means that you have to give the example, right? Here, as much as possible, try to give the current affairs example. So this is the kind of question. In the 1857 uprising was the culmination of recurrent big and small local rebellions that had occurred in the preceding 100 years of British rule. Elucidate, okay? Elucidate means make it clear. So you will give detailed explanation, right? You will basically narrate the event, and then you will also reach out to the point that okay, yes, this is right. Next is this another question from the same dimension. Many voices had strengthened and enriched the nationalist movement during the Gandhian phase. Elaborate. So this statement they have again used. Now the next word is the implication, the consequence, outcome, or result. Okay, so this is talking about what can be the possible impact or possible scenario, and this is the kind of question they have asked in the previous year. Effective utilization of public fund is the crucial to meet the developmental goals. Critically examine the reasons for underutilization and misutilization of public fund and their implications, right? So they have used two words here simultaneously, critically examine, and they have also used the implications, right? So you have to give answer to as per both the terms. Then we have contrast or distinguish or differences. So here you have to talk about the differences. For example, this simple question from the UPSC. So I am trying to give you more and more UPSC questions only so that you are able to see that UPSC questions have all these points, and you can prepare your answer writing in the similar way. So what is the water stress? How and why does it differ regionally in India? Simply, right? Difference they are asking regionally. Similarly, next question is about distinguish between the code of ethics and the code of conduct with suitable examples, right? Now, significance or importance. This is another dimension. So here you can tell what happens if it exists or what will not happen if it does not exist. Matlab uski zarurat kya hai? For example, throw light on the significance of the thoughts of Mahatma Gandhi in the present times. This is again the UPSC question. So here, what is the importance of thoughts of Mahatma Gandhi that has to be told? Then justify or advocate. In the justify or advocate, you have to give the favorable or not favorable comment. So non-performance of duty by a public servant is a form of corruption. Do you agree with this view? Justify your answer. So you have to, give evidence to your views. You have to, justify your answer. You have to give logic. You have to give the rational view, right? Then next is illustrate. Illustrate means give the example. So for in the example, you can include the different diagram, data, figure, chart, graph. Okay. So in the illustrate, you have to give the proper example. You have to basically give in detail. What are the basic principles of public life? Illustrate any three of these with a suitable example. Okay. So they are asking for the example. Next is measures. What is to be done for the implementation of any policy? So for example, the question is about city and charter, right? तो मेजर्स टू बी टेकन फॉर इफेक्टिवनेस ऑफ द सिटीजन चार्टर. ओके, सजेस्ट द मेजर्स. सो अगेन दिस इज लाइक द स्टेप विच आर रिक्वायर्ड टू बी टेकन फॉर इंप्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ ए पॉलिसी सक्सेसफुली. देन कंपेयर कंट्रास्ट और या कंपेयर एंड कंट्रास्ट. ओके, सो हियर यू हैव टू राइट बोथ द सिमिलैरिटीज एंड द डिफरेंसेस. राइट, यू हैव टू राइट बोथ सिमिलैरिटीज एंड द डिफरेंसेस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, कंपेयर एंड कंट्रास्ट tenets of Buddhism and Jainism. How far are these religious ideas relevant to present day modern India? So Buddhism, Jainism, उनकी में आपको contrast and compare करना है और उनकी आज के समय में क्या relevance है वो आपको बतानी है. Right? So here you have to give the similarities and differences both. Now coming to the very important part of the session, that is what kind of mistake are done by the people. लोग किस तरह की mistake अपने answers में करते हैं. Let us look into that, okay? And this is very, very important so that you don't repeat this kind of mistake. And let me tell you, we have made this list of mistake based upon our experience of past so many years of evaluating so many copies. So, you know, this is based upon my research, the research of my team. I discussed with my evaluation team again and again that what kind of mistake the people are making. And based upon that research, we have found that these are the most common mistake which people have done. So let us see this mistake. Grammar or spelling mistake. This is a big problem. Okay, don't do that. Grammar or spelling problem. मैंने भी कर दिए आपको दिखाने के लिए. आपको पता चले कि grammar mistake भी हो सकती है. Okay, spelling mistake भी हो सकती है. Okay, not answering to the demand of the question. If there is a question and we have read the question somewhere, there is a tendency that you will write whatever you know rather than looking into what is the demand of the question. And I have found it more than, you know, more often than not. You will just write what you know rather than what is required. Aapke paas mein, for example, there is a topic of, say, disinvestment. You will just write those points which you know, or you will try to include those dimensions rather than looking into whether ki question mein वो पूछा भी गया था या नहीं पूछा गया था. इफ द क्वेश्चन इज नॉट आस्किंग फॉर दैट डायमेंशन, देन व्हाई आर यू राइटिंग दैट डायमेंशन. ओके, सो यू हैव टू एक्चुअली आंसर द डिमांड ऑफ द क्वेश्चन, नॉट एक्सप्लेनिंग एज पर द टैग वर्ड. तो जो मैंने आपको बताया 18 वर्ड, जस्टिफाई और इंप्लीकेशन और क्रिटिकल एग्जामिन और एल्यूसिडेट और इलाबोरेट, ऑल ऑफ देम हैव डिफरेंट मीनिंग. या मे बी देर आर फ्यू वर्ड विच माई बी हैविंग लाइक वेरी यू नो क्लोज रिलेशनशिप, जहां पर हम लोग बहुत ज्यादा डिफरेंशिएट नहीं कर सकते. बट इन मेनी वर्ड देयर इज अ क्लियर इंडिकेशन दैट वी हैव टू आंसर इन अ पर्टिकुलर वे. फॉर एग्जांपल, यू नो व्हेन वी हैव टू गिव द लिस्ट, देन वी हैव टू गिव द लिस्ट ओनली, नथिंग. इफ वी हैव टू गिव द डेफिनेशन, देन वी हैव टू गिव द डेफिनेशन. वी कांट डू समथिंग एल्स. नॉट हैविंग प्रॉपर स्ट्रक्चर. राइट, नॉट राइटिंग इंट्रोडक्शन, बॉडी, कंक्लूजन इन द प्रॉपर मैनर. देन क्रॉसिंग द वर्ड लिमिट. When you start the answer writing in the initial time, you try to increase your answer thinking that you will be able to get extra marks, but that may not be possible. Writing irrelevant content just to fill the answer sheet. This is not the graduation examination. Don't do that. And unable to use the space wisely. You are just unnecessarily making very, very big diagram. Okay? Then lot of space by the diagram, I already told you. Data. People are not using the data, right? See friends, you may not be having the data for every question, but the point is you can have the approximate data, right? Try utilizing the approximate data if you don't write the exact data. Repetition of point. This is also like you are just repeating the same point in different language or different word. You are trying to fool the examiner, but this cannot be done. If you don't know much point, don't write. Don't waste your time and space. Don't try to get the penalty for the examiner. Varna examiner penalty nahi deta hai aajkal. Theek hai? Aapko wo nahi karna hai. Lack of diversity of the point. Right? Basically, what people are doing, they are writing the point from the same dimension again and again. They are basing the different dimension. Right? So please, write the dimension rather than the point only. Okay? Then, for enriching your answer and for ensuring that one line give you one extra mark, you have to use certain revision tools. You must have the one page mind map for very important topic. At least 500 mind map you should have with your own hand in your file. Then exam time synopsis of all the topics, so that before the examination you are able to recall all the point and you can reproduce the very effective point in the exam hall. Try to make revision audio or video clip of your own material. Use acronym, and topic wise preparation has to be done, not fragmented. Means don't try to compile unnecessary data from here and there. If you are using some data, write in the notebook of that particular topic, right? Have the same, you know, have all the possible data, all the possible dimension or case study diagram of same topic at single place, so that in the exam you can actually utilize that. Otherwise there will be complete wastage of time. Finally, have patience. This is a skill. आप साइकिल चलाना पहले दिन में नहीं सीखे थे, तो आंसर राइटिंग में मास्टरी करने में आपको टाइम लग सकता है. बट आई एम प्रोमिसिंग, इफ यू फॉलो ऑल दीज टेक्निक्स, इन जस्ट 3 months यू कैन बी द मास्टर ऑफ आंसर राइटिंग. यू मस्ट हैव ए पर्सनल मेंटोर, समवन हु कैन सी योर प्रोग्रेस फ्रॉम बिगिनिंग टू द एंड. अदरवाइज यू विल कीप वेस्टिंग योर टाइम डूइंग द रिचुअल्स. डोंट डू रिचुअल्स. Don't just think that I will write one answer and this is done. No, you have to see the mistake, you have to see the self-evaluation, you have to rewrite the answer, and you have to ensure that next time this mistake will not be repeated no matter what. So don't do ritual. Try to work on the real mistake and try to improve really on daily basis. Means on Monday and this Monday, next Monday, there should be, you know, drastic difference in your answer writing. Make a mistake register. This is very very important. जितनी mistake आपकी होती है उसका register बनाना है, so that next time when you are writing the answer you do not repeat the same mistake again and again. And in the prelims you are writing, you are solving MCQ. Here in the mains examination just do brainstorming, nothing else. Try making the structure of all possible questions. If you can't write every answer, not a problem. Try making the structure. Start thinking about what can be the introduction, what can be the conclusion. Try to have 2-3 introduction for every answer. Try to have 2-3 conclusion for every answer. Try to have different diagram format with yourself. Okay? So brainstorming, thinking, analyzing that what can I do, what can I do, that will take you to the next level. No one can do that thing for you. You have to do yourself. Okay? Now introducing our program of the daily answer writing plus enrichment. So we are having a wonderful program where we are having limited seats, limited 20 seats for this premium batch, where answer evaluation will be done within 12 hours. And if you write today, you will get the evaluation before next day answer, so that you can incorporate the evaluation remarks and you can improve the same day. You don't have to wait for the 72 hours. Normally in the other programs we are having the evaluation within 72 hours, but in this premium batch where we are having 20 seats, we will be having 12 hours deadline. Okay, we will be providing live interactive sessions and evaluations and discussions just like this only for important topic, not for every topic, not for every question, but those questions which are like challenging, where you need the discussion, right? Then we will work upon most probable 450 plus GS mains and 20 plus SA, right? Then one-to-one interaction with the evaluator will be there. We will have the system and we will be providing you mind map, key facts, case studies, all those things which I told you that you should include, right? So that research we have done on your behalf, right? And this is a daily process. So we have a personal dashboard. You will get the personal dashboard. Your question will be available in the night 12 a.m. On daily basis, you can download that question and you can write the answer on the hard copy. You can scan the answer sheet by any mobile application. Upload the answer in the personal dashboard within maximum 24 hours, right? Maximum 24 hours ke andar. If you don't upload, then you cannot upload. Why we are putting the time limit? So that there is a discipline. So that you have in your mind that if I don't submit, I will miss something. Then you can download the model answer immediately. Your answer will be evaluated within 12 hours or 72 hours as per the choice you have taken. The answer discussion will happen and you will be, you know, getting the maximum benefit from your preparation. So this is the some of the important features. And this time we are having some unique features in our program. we will be allocating one personal mentor for each student so that you can talk about your issues with the mentor. And there will be 24 hour Telegram query doubt handle, a separate handle, and that handle will be managed by the evaluation team. So our evaluation team has experts, those people who have given the interview at least once, and that evaluation team will be having access to this handle. You will be also having the access to this handle. So just type your name, the name of your mentor, type your query, and that will be replied back by your mentor. This is a 24 hour facility which we are providing so that you don't feel a gap between you and your evaluator. This facility is not given by anywhere, in any program of India. That is what I know, right? So this facility I am providing so that you can work upon your you can work upon your answer writing rather than waiting for the time to pass. And personal dashboard for every student, okay, where you'll be getting the all the answers, questions, everything. So these are various toppers of the previous batches, and I have been part of this program. This is our another wonderful program. If you don't know, let me tell you, this is like for content development, and we'll be providing live interactive classes to the point study material on 900 plus topic. And very important, this is covering both static and the current portion. Normally only static portion is covered, current is not covered. But we are sorry, current is covered, static is not covered, and we are covering both. And we are covering three papers, GS1, GS2, GS3. And we are providing exam time synopsis. That means every topic covered in 100 to 200 words so that you can revise before the exam. Short revision clip of 5 minutes so that you can revise before the exam. And we are also discussing the daily answers, but evaluation is not available. And this is completely exam oriented batch. I am the lead faculty, and then there are other faculty. We have also come up with the ethics batch. In this ethics batch, we are working on the marks maximizing tools. So this is a very short batch, 30 hour class, 30 hours only, live doubt clearing sessions. We will be working on providing you powerful quotations, short definitions, handmade diagrams, real life examples, case studies, UPSC previous year question analysis, brainstorming. For the ethics paper, it will be different kind of brainstorming, and best point from the toppers copies we will be telling you. So lot of research has been done, and this will be taken by another faculty, and you will be getting lot of benefit. Our purpose is that you increase your marks to at least 120 plus marks in this single paper, right? So this is our effort. Then we have another program for the essay. In the essay also, we are working to increase the score from average 120 to 150 marks. So for that, we have just 20 hour module where there will be thematic discussion. Thematic means on every theme, we will give you four topic. We will discuss how we can convert the basic thing into the concrete thing. We can give the example how we can structure everything in this module. And in this module, there is no evaluation, but we will give the test and we will give the feedback, but no one-to-one evaluation. For evaluation, we have extra facility. Apart from that, on our website, we are providing various wonderful tools, NCERT revision notes, daily current affairs, MCQs, wonderful. I mean, you will find it like it is of, you know, best quality current affair, which you are providing, right? Best optional strategy, Margdarshan webinars, which we are having right now. Next webinar is on Monday, which is about essay writing. Free revision compilation for various subject, and UPSC previous year question with the proper analysis, right? So I invite you to visit our website and be there, okay? And let me show you a website. So this is our website, and the website you can get free resources where you will find webinars, free download section where you will find the PPTs of these webinars. And in fact, I will upload the PPT of this webinar in this page only. So you can get economy webinar, current affair webinar, other webinars. We are having wonderful courses where we are providing you Maze Booster program, answer writing program, essay writing, prelims cum mains batch, ethics, economy, GS2, GS3, notes, and some other programs. I will invite you to go through this UPSC mains booster program where you will find the wonderful notes. You will click here in the sample PDF, etc. You go to this folder, you go to, for example, this GS2, you find different kind of mind map you can make. We have given the example. You can learn from here. And we have prepared this for the important topics. Then similarly, you can see the different other sources, how to make the mind maps, how to make the exam time synopsis. So you can see role of civil services in India. So just one page, entire topic is covered. Okay, less than one page. Okay, role of NGO, only one page, entire topic is covered. Role of self-help group, only one page, entire topic is covered. So this is the kind of integration which we are providing, and this is like best kind of integration that we have done for this. And we have provided the 900 plus topic list. You can click here and you can download this topic list which you must prepare for your examination, right? And we will add 100 more topics here. You can work upon those topic also. So this list is available. You must prepare all these topics for your mains preparation, right?